A judge says Missouri's last abortion clinic can remain open. The ruling comes hours before the Planned Parenthood facility's license was set to expire. Government officials threatened not to renew it, citing concerns over compromised patient safety and legal violations. But the circuit judge issued a temporary restraining order. A hearing is set for Tuesday. Louisiana's Democratic Governor John Bel Edwards, a practicing Catholic, signs the state's heartbeat bill. It bans abortion once a baby's heartbeat is detected. The law takes effect only if neighboring Mississippi's heartbeat bill is upheld in a federal appeals court. Hollywood studio executives say they may reevaluate filming in Georgia if that state's heartbeat law goes into effect. This week, studio chiefs from Netflix, the Walt Disney Company, and Warner Media, which includes HBO, Turner, and Warner Brothers, all issued statements indicating they're reviewing the situation. Netflix chief content officer implied their company is considering a boycott. Jay Richards joins me now. He's the host of EWTN programs A Force for Good and business professor at the Catholic University of America. Jay, welcome back to the broadcast.
Great to be with you.
Thanks to generous tax credits, the city of Atlanta has become a major hub of TV, film production. What do you make of these potential boycotts from a financial standpoint?
Well, what's strange about it is we've gone from individual citizens boycotting companies to companies boycotting people, segments of the population. I think we've got to look at it in two ways. I mean, the reality is that Netflix is, frankly, deeply involved with Planned Parenthood, and so I think this reflects actually kind of an ideological commitment, at least on the part of some of the leadership. At the same time, it's really a bad business decision, I think, because the reality is that companies save millions of dollars by producing programs in Atlanta and in Georgia. I mean, there's a reason they're going to Georgia rather than California, because it in many cases means millions of dollars. And so what Netflix is really doing is I think they're banking on politicians in Georgia not being bold and backing down easily. But if they really had to boycott the state, I think the company could end up losing millions of dollars. So I honestly think at the moment they're counting on a buckle by the politicians in Georgia.
Well, to follow up on that, in general, how much of a risk is it for companies to take a position that puts them at odds with more conservative viewpoints?
Well, in this case, I mean, they're protesting Georgia's heartbeat abortion law, which about 70% of the population apparently supports. And so they're actually not just against social conservatives in general, but a majority of Americans, and I suspect a supermajority in Georgia. And so they themselves, I think, risk a boycott. And I've noticed already on social media that people are unsubscribing from Netflix. And so that's something that I think in their minds, they know there's a risk there, but at the moment they assume that siding with social secularists and leftists is a better bet. They're assuming that the people on the left and the LGBT activists, the Planned Parenthood folks, are more of a threat to them than social conservatives at the moment.
It seems like in this day and age we hear more about companies, big companies, taking a stand on political issues. From a business perspective, would it be better for big companies just not to take a position on any political issue, whether it be a conservative or a liberal one?
I mean, I think that makes sense, especially with issues that honestly divide the American people. I mean, abortion, marriage, these are issues that are very important to people on opposite sides of the spectrum. It doesn't make any sense to me from a purely business calculation that companies would weigh in, especially when the business has nothing to do with it. I mean, Netflix doesn't have anything to do with healthcare or abortion or any of those sorts of things. And so I think what we're seeing is a mix of ideological commitment on the part of the leadership and then a calculation that they have more to gain than to lose by siding with one side of the culture war. And I think it's up to social conservatives to persuade them that they're mistaken in that calculation.
Well, it's so interesting to hear more about this, and obviously we'll continue to follow as people speak out against this. Jay Richards, host of EWTN program Force for Good, and of course business professor at the Catholic University of America. Thanks for your analysis.
My pleasure, Wyatt. Good to be with you.